Well, you probably figure I look familiar, and I probably should. I've been on the island for a while. But if you don't know, my name is Dave Wright, and Lauren gave me a call from Ptarmigan and said, "Well, we can't do the live soup luncheon on the Fridays like we normally do." But she said, "You know, what do you think of maybe doing a little video?" So that's exactly what I'm doing. I'm kind of holed up here, just doing a little video and a little audio for you. And I thought, you know, it might be interesting to just go back to my very roots of where I started, which was many, many moon ago. And I started out as a folk singer as a kid. And I was just kind of going through some tunes and stuff and trying to think, you know, what would I do for this little occasion today? And I thought, I'm going to go back to the very, very beginning, to where my roots started, which would be, you know, Gordon Lightfoot and Ian Tyson and some other folks like that. So, but I'll give you a little tune here. It's called "Train Leaves Here This Morning." It was one of the first tunes that I learned. It was by the Dillards. I think some other folks came along and recorded it later, but. Well, this is my version of "There's a Train Leaves Here This Morning." I lost 10 points just for being in exactly the wrong place at the right time. Well, I look round for the facts there, but I may as well have been completely blind. So if you see me walking all alone, don't look back, I'm just on my way back home. There's a train leaves here this morning, and I don't know what I might be on. I don't know what I might be on. 1320 North Columbus was the address I had written on my sleeve. Might have been some kind of reason, might have been that she was getting time to leave. But if time makes a difference while we're gone, just tell me now that I won't be hanging on. There's a train leaves here this morning, I don't know what I might be on. She signed me up to a contract, baby said it would be all life long. When I looked round for a reason, well, there wasn't nothing left to blame it on. And I watched as the toker passed it on. And I laughed when the smoker said, "Lead on." There's a train leaves here this morning, I don't know what I might be on. I don't know what I might be on. I lost 10 points just for being in exactly the wrong place at the right time. Well, I look round for a reason, but I may as well have been completely blind. So if you see me walking all alone, don't look back, I'm just on my way. way back home. There's a train leaves here this morning. I don't know what I might be on. There's a train leaves here this morning. I don't know what I might be on. I don't know what I might be on. Yeah, so that was one of the first songs that I learned, and I started my folk music career at the ripe old age of, I think, 13, playing down at a little pizza place in Edmonton in the basement, a place called Giuseppe's, and that's where a lot of these tunes were sort of born from. I'll do a song that was. I think it was originally done by Ian and Sylvia. They weren't the writers, but it's a beautiful song, and they became known for it, and it's a kind of an old country song, not country and western, but sort of original country song that Ian has gone back to writing tunes like this, but it's a thing called Darcy Farrell. Walker rolls down to the Carson Valley Plain. There lived a maiden, Darcy Farrell was her name. The daughter of old Dundee, a fair one she. The sweetest flower that bloomed over the range. Well, she was courted by young Vandermeer, and quite handsome was he, so in here. He bought her rings and other fancy things, and she promised to wed before the first rose of spring. But her pony did stumble, she did fall. Her dying touched the hearts of us one and all. Young Bandy in his pain put a bullet through his brain, and they buried them together before the snow began to fall. Oh, the sing of Darcy Farrell, where the truck he runs through. They sing of Darcy Farrell in Virginia City too. And by dusky sundown, to the name they drink around. And to young Bandy, whose love was true. Where the Walker rolls down through the Carson Valley Plain. There lived a maiden, Darcy Farrell was her name. The daughter of old Dundee, and a fair one was she. The sweetest flower that bloomed on the range. The sweetest flower that bloomed on the range. Right. So that was Darcy Farrell. You'll notice I'm wearing the official bluegrass folk music hat. There's a story that goes with the hat. And eventually in my musical progress, I ended up playing bluegrass in a bluegrass band for a number of years, 10 years or so, Jerusalem Ridge. And one of the stories we came across when we were touring down in the southern United States was a story about the father of bluegrass, Bill Monroe. And those that don't know, it's a pretty small outfit as far as bluegrass goes. It has a small following, but a loyal following. And Bill was unquestionably the king of the business. And if you were a bluegrass boy in his backup band, you had to wear this hat, and not unlike one of these. And he had a young fiddle player who just going off first time on the road with Bill, Glenn Duncan. And Glenn was probably one of the finest fiddle players in his genre. And anyway, they were stopping for an RC Cola somewhere with the band bus. And Glenn came off the bus, and Mr. Monroe was standing there. And Glenn said to him, he said, "You know, Mr. Monroe," he said, "this is a real honor to be playing in your band." He said, "Just one thing," he said, "do I have to wear the hat?" He said, "I'm not fussy about it." And Mr. Monroe said, "No, son, you don't have to wear the hat." And so everybody wandered into the diner and had their RC Colas and whatnot, and then they came out, and lo and behold, the bus pulled away, minus one Glenn Duncan, who didn't want to wear the hat. So as many people who have worked for Mr. Monroe know, the watchword with Monroe was that you gotta wear the hat if you want to play in the band. So it's just a little story for you that I picked up on the road. What shall I do? Here's a nice tune. This is a tune by a real wonderful flat picker. It's Tony Rice. Tony's just wonderful, so I'm gonna I got nothing on Tony, so you're just gonna have to live with this one. But it's called Church Street Blues. It was written by Norman Blake. Uptown in this low-down rain, watching good time charter friends is driving me insane. Up on shady Sharp Street, don't the green lights sure look red? I wish I was back home on the farm in my feather bed. Got myself a rocking chair, see if I could lose this thin dime, hard time, hello Church Street Blues. Got myself a pick a friend, read yesterday's news. I folded up page 21 and I threw it in my shoe. Gave the nickel for the poor, my good deed for the day. I folded up my old billfold, threw it far away. And I got myself a rocking chair to see if I could lose these thin dime, hard time, hello Church Street Blues. Up an old black diamond brand, I'll string up this old Martin box, go and join some band. Yes, I'm gonna stay right here, pick and sing a while, try to make a little noise, give you folks a smile. And I got myself a rocking chair, see if I could lose these thin dime, hard time, hello Cherry Street Blues. I got them thin dime, hard time, hello Cherry Street Blues. Church Street Blues. So that's another one that goes quite a ways back. Tony's a heck of a flat picker. Probably took me about 5 years to learn that, actually learn how to play that kind of style. Ever feel lonesome and you're down in San Antone, beg, steal, or borrow two nickels or a dime, call me on the phone. I'll meet you at Alamo Mission, where we can say our prayer. Holy Ghost and the Virgin Mother will heal us as we kneel there in the moonlight, in the midnight, in the moonlight, midnight, moonlight, in the midnight, in the moonlight, in the midnight, moonlight, midnight. Ever feel lonesome for the deeds that you have done? No hope for tomorrow in the setting of the sun. The ocean is howling of the things that might have been, and the last good morning sunrise will be the brightest you've ever seen. In the midnight, in the moonlight, in the midnight, moonlight, midnight, in the midnight, in the moonlight, midnight, moonlight, midnight. Ever feel lonesome and you're down in San Antone, beg, steal, or borrow two nickels or a dime, call me on the phone. Meet you at Alamo Mission and we can say our prayer. Holy Ghost and the Virgin Mother will heal us, and we kneel there. In the midnight, in the moonlight, in the midnight, moonlight, midnight. In the midnight, in the moonlight, in the midnight, midnight, moonlight. It's a tune called Midnight Moonlight. I can't even recall who that's by. Here's an old Ian Tyson tune that Ian actually wrote. This was after he and Sylvia went their separate ways, and Ian came west and was setting up his quarter horse ranch just down in southern Alberta. This song most most folks will know if they know anything of Ian Tyson. Never hit 17 when you play against the dealer, for you know the odds won't ride with you. Never leave your woman alone when your friends are out to steal her. She may be gambled and gone like summer waves. So we'll keep rolling on till we get to Vancouver, for the woman that I love is living there. It's been 6 long months, maybe more, since I've seen her. She may be gambled and gone like summer waves. All your beer parlors, all down the long Main Street, dreams of the seasons are all spilled down on the floor. And the big stands of timber just waiting for the falling. The hustlers sit and watch for me, they wait there by the door. So I'll work on them towboats in my city slippery shoes, but I swore I'd never do again. Through the great fog-bound straits where the cedars stand watching, I'll be far off and gone like summer waves. Summer Wages. I grew up on down east for a bit, and then moved to the prairies to Edmonton. And those songs about moving to Vancouver and stuff always used to grab me. And some of my gigs back in the folky days did bring me to Vancouver. And all these many years now, I've kind of overshot Vancouver, and now I live on this tiny little beautiful island, Pender Island, and no regrets. Actually, only regret is I didn't get here 40 years ago instead of 10 years ago. Anyway. In the early morning rain, with a dollar in my hand, in my heart and my pocket full of sand, I'm a long ways from home and I miss my loved ones so.
in the early morning rain, with no place to go, out of runway number 9, it's 707 said to go. I'm stuck here on the ground, where the cold winds will blow. Liquor tasted good, and the women all were fast. Well, there she goes, my friend. Yes, she's going now at last. Hear the mighty engines roar. See the silver bird on my eye. Westward bound, far above the clouds she'll fly, where the morning rain don't fall and the sun always shines. She'll be flying over my home in about 3 hours' time. This old airport lets me down. It's no worth the good to me. Well, I'm stuck here on the ground, cold and drunk as I can be. Can't jump a jet plane like you can a freight train. So I best be on my way in the early morning. Jet plane like you can a freight train. So best be on my way in the early morning rain.
Suppose you, if you don't know that song, or at least know a couple of verses of it, then you'd be hard pressed to call yourself a Canadian. Of course, that was Gordon Lightfoot. A little thing called More Pretty Girls. There's more pretty girls than one. There's more pretty girls than one. Well, any old town that I ramble all around, there's more pretty girls than one. Well, Mama talked to me last night. She gave to me some good advice. She said, son, you ought to quit that old rambling all around and marry a sweet loving wife. There's more pretty girls than one. There's more pretty girls than one. Well, any old town that I ramble all around, Lord's more pretty girls than one. Now look on down that lonesome road. Hang down your head and cry. Well, I'm thinking of about all them pretty little gals, and I'm hoping that I never die. Well, there's more pretty girls than one. More pretty girls than one. Any old town that I ramble all around,
said, in your town that I ramble all around, there's more pretty girls than one. Well, in your town that I ramble all around, there's more pretty girls than one.
Well, I got a little piece of that. And hang on, let me just finish up here with a little thing. No folk singer's repertoire would be complete without a tune by Doc Watson. Especially when it's followed up by a cover version by Johnny Cash. That's a thing, it was written by the Delmore brothers, Ray Vaughan and Alonzo. You couldn't buy names like that. Those are definitely, they come from the hills and the hollers for sure. And this thing called, the Delmore brothers, they called it the Big River Blues, but I think it's come to be known better as Deep River Blues. But here we go.
Sinks with me, Lordy, I'll go down now. Don't you see, cause I got them deep river blues. Well, I'm going down to Muscle Shoals. Times are better there now, Lord, I've been told. I get them deep river blues. If my boat sinks with me, Lord, I'll go down. And don't you see? Well, I got them deep river blues. Well, let it rain, let it pour, let it all rain a whole lot more. Well, I got them deep river blues. Let that rain drive right along, let them old waves sweep right along, cause I got them deep river blues. Well, I got them deep river blues.